Thank you for joining us to learn how you and your team can track the effectiveness of your emails. In this video, you will learn about the most important metrics to track and see where you stack up against industry standards. Let's get started.
What is email marketing? Email's digital marketing strategy to convert leads into customers and to increase the retention of customers. So, you know, we get emails all the time, and this is the most common number one form of communication. And over time, it's proven to be the best way to actually get someone's attention. The reason is that when I send someone an email, you know, we know we're always looking at our email every day, but it forces me to do something. Like I have to perform an action. I'm going to delete the email, right click, move to junk. I'm going to open it. I'm going to look at it. So now I've opened it. I've performed some action, maybe some semi bit of intent. And then I'm looking at this email, something looks interesting, I click on it. Now I've really shown intent that something is actually interesting in this email that I've chosen to open. But this process we go through thousands of times a week, or at least hundreds of times a week, with the stuff that we get in our inbox. One of the challenges with email marketing is that statistically over the last maybe, really over the last 3 years, but probably the last 10 years, the numbers in success of things like how many people opened it, how many people clicked on something, are getting lower and lower and lower because of technology. So things like the other tab in your Outlook, things like the priority inbox in Gmail, what they're doing is they're pushing this really super important content that we really want you to read out of your main view. So it takes strategy, techniques, A/B testing to figure out how do I get right into your primary inbox? How do I get into the main view of what you're going to see? And how do I affect these five key metrics that you need to really monitor when you're looking at the performance of your email? So we have the open rate, which means I've actually opened your email, the click-through rate, which means I clicked something on that email through to whatever page. And the way, you know, if you're not really familiar with this topic, when you click on something and it's that long string after a URL, what's happening is the backend system is actually going to know that it was you specifically that clicked it, what you clicked, when you clicked, what campaign it was. That goes into your Google Analytics, that goes into whatever backend database you might be using, Marketo, HubSpot, et cetera, and that's all part of this big amount of data that you're starting to collect. So imagine if you send out, you know, a million emails, and you do this every Tuesday and Thursday, and you do this for five straight years, you are getting a ton of data based on open rate, click-through rate, unsubscribe rate, et cetera. So the click-to-open rate is actually, okay, how many people actually clicked after they opened? 14%. Is that good or bad? I was actually reading an article, I don't know, over the weekend, I think, and it said, oh, your goal is 30%. So I'm reading this article and I'm reading and I'm reading and I'm reading. I'm like, where does it tell me like anything about where they came up with this 30%? It was such a generic metric. And that's the point. All of these metrics are specific to your vertical industry. So my unsubscribe rate might be 0.1%. Yours might be 70%. Why? Well, maybe it's because it's your vertical industry. What's your bounce rate, et cetera? So the key metric here is the click to open rate. And you need to start examining that maybe across verticals to see where everyone is at, but really where does your industry fit in this click to open rate? So what we highlighted here was some, you know, outliers, the lowest and the highest, right? So in the agriculture, forestry, and fishing industry, the click-to-open rate is around 18%. And in the nonprofit industry, the click-to-open rate is around 10%. So we can start making all kinds of assumptions about this. Like, I'm a fisherman, and I'm looking for that new lure because I'm going fishing. And so maybe the lure manufacturing and new releases only come out a couple times a year. So when you get those emails, everyone's real interested in kind of seeing what's new. Nonprofit, you already know what's going to happen. They're asking you for money. So you see this email come in, help us here. We got this new initiative. Like, I don't have any money now. I can't really help. But the point is, you need to know where you fit in. So when you're giving a presentation to your management team, or when you're the product marketing person giving results to the VP of marketing, don't just say, hey, we need to hit a metric of 20%. If historically your metric is in the 8% range or the 12% range, know your industry, know how you stack up. And this is like an eye test to read, which is why we make the slides available in SlideShare, because we're not going to go through any of this, but you'll be able to go and find your industry. And we've put together this information so then you can use it to start helping you make decisions on your email performance for open rate, click-through rate. This is like unbelievable information. And then, of course, the best day to send an email, research shows Tuesdays and Thursdays. Now, Tuesdays and Thursdays, there's other industry metrics, like what's the best day to do a webinar? It's like Tuesday or Wednesday and Thursday. So there's a couple days a week where it's a good idea to do webinars on these days. You know, don't do them at Friday at 4 o'clock, right? Because, you know, no one's going to show up. And definitely don't do them on Sundays or Saturdays. You know, so this is all researched. So if you're going to send out emails, and go back and check, you know, like I was talking to Casey this morning about subjects, and we were analyzing subjects of political campaigns. And it's amazing how well researched political campaigns are on what the subject is and how they know their demographics so well. But they hammer you on Tuesdays, they hammer you on Thursdays. And by the way, they hammer you a lot, but you do get a flood of inbox emails on those days. Now that elections, especially if you live in the United States, are coming up, you're pretty much getting like 8 emails a day. But in general, they're using these techniques to drive you to the result that they're actually looking for. So we'll wrap up the email side and talk about these 8 ways to improve your performance. Send emails on the highest performing days. We discussed Tuesdays and Thursdays there. Segment out your lists. This is critical. Like I gave the example of where the developers are versus where the purchasers are, but you know. The messaging, the colors, you know, the pictures, there's so many things that you need to consider to get the best result. When you look at list segmentation, you really need to understand your audience and what they expect. Make sure your emails are mobile friendly. I had a talk this morning with our CEO. He was not happy because one of our SaaS apps sent over an email and automated. It was 100% automated. And he looked at his mobile and he was like, this thing is garbage. Like, it doesn't look good. I looked at it. I'm like, yeah, it needs some work. Doesn't look that bad. But guess what? You need to live up to your brand. So mobile, everything must be mobile today. If it's not mobile, you're going to lose a huge segment of your customers. In fact, many of the digital natives, this is their primary tool. This is where they're reading their email. So if they can't read it, you're never going to get a message to them. And digital natives, I think, are people born, was it after 1995 or something like that? No, 1991. I think it's 1991. Is that the digital native, Casey? I actually forget. But it's someone who's grown up, yeah, with digital. They were born with a phone in their hand or something like that.
I would think 95.
Okay. Yeah, that's like, so you'd be about 25 years old if you were born there, something like that, 24. Yeah. But it's pretty amazing. I was on a flight once coming back from San Francisco. And I was talking to this person next to me, and I'm a high-tech guy, right? And I've got my iPhone, got my iPad. And I said, like, where's your iPad? How do you watch movies and stuff? And he was like, what do you mean? Why would I need an iPad? I have everything I need on my phone, right? So even when it comes to digital natives, they do things on the phone. The iPad is sort of just like this thing maybe work gave them to do stuff on. Test between text emails and image-based emails. You know, we made a lot of assumptions around text where, oh, a text email will always get through. Well, that's not so true anymore. So like email messages, spam filters, and the other filters started to really filter those out within the last 5 years. And we said, well, text-based will work. Text-based still is not guaranteed to work because these tools are using AI to examine subject and content to determine if it deserves to be in your inbox. So you have to test this. Have your email come from a generic person instead of a generic email. You know, at Infragistics, we test this all the time, and you'll see emails from Casey. You'll see emails from Jason. You'll see emails from team at Infragistics. You'll see emails from team at Reveal BI. We're constantly testing to see not only what gets the most open rate, but based on the email, what gets the most engagement. So for example, I might not get a click-through on an email that comes from Jason B, but I may get a reply. Hey, Jason, I'm a customer for 5 years. I downloaded Reveal. I tried this visualization out. Can I do this with it as well? So there's also that aspect of it. If it was at team@infragistics.com, it always goes to that generic inbox and we might get it in a couple of days. So test that as well. Compelling subject line. What I can say about compelling subject lines is, honestly, if you haven't, go subscribe to every political campaign that you can and look at their subject lines and look at how they are getting these tens to hundreds of millions of dollars in donations a month, because they're getting a high volume of opens and clicks based on the subject. And the other thing is, people get really annoyed when you try to trick them. So I got an email a few years ago. I went to Build, a Microsoft event, and the email after said, "You forgot your jacket at Build." I'm like, "Oh crap, I forgot my jacket." I clicked on it. It was like a marketing spam, you know? So anyway, not a good idea to try to trick people. Include personalization through tokens. So when you do segmentation and you know who the person is, when they click that link, make sure that page they go to is highly personalized and it's like to their name, to their company, to what they are looking for. And then, of course, have a clear call to action, like download now, view this video. So John, who runs the webinars and he runs all of the video channels, he has metrics and KPIs on how many people watch videos, how many people, when he sends an email, click watch this video. So he needs to ensure that if he has an email with 4 call to actions, what's his primary call to action? And are the other maybe secondary or tertiary call to actions clear that he's going to still be able to achieve metrics based on those calls to action? So very important.
Be sure to check out the next video in this series where we dive into the key performance metrics of your digital advertising ecosystem. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Reveal BI.